Hello, I'm Dr. Norma Jones. Welcome to our short video about using AI in class. Let's get started. Introduction. In this video, we will review some quick tips for using artificial intelligence, or AI, in your class. Overview. We will cover the following elements. First, a brief introduction of AI. Second, prompt engineering. Third, checking facts. Fourth, editing, and fifth, citing and referencing. A brief introduction of AI. Before we introduce AI, here's a way to consider how we could use the tools of AI. More specifically, in the film The Big Lebowski, the character known as The Stranger, portrayed by Sam Elliott, delivers a memorable quote, "Sometimes you eat the bear, and sometimes the bear, well, he eats you." While this line did not originate from this movie, the metaphor captures the ever-changing relationship between humans and AI. Eating the bear can symbolize successfully utilizing and managing AI for our benefit, while the bear eating you could represent the potential for AI to replace or control humans. We need to ensure we manage AI instead of being controlled by artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence, or AI, is using computer systems in ways that are similar to human brains. We are already using some AI in navigation systems, like GPS and Maps for Apple. Many of us also use Grammarly to help with our writing. Even our phones learn our preferences and suggest different words when we type. More recently, several companies have options for chatbots that respond to our questions using natural language. In contrast, search engines like Google give us a list of websites. One of the most popular chatbots right now is OpenAI's ChatGPT. Since this is an emergent technology, other companies are rapidly launching similar chatbots. Prompt engineering, writing and refining prompts. As noted previously, chatbots answer your questions in what may be considered a dialogue between you and the chatbot. Your questions are also called prompts. When the chatbot answers, those are called responses. The chatbot's responses can be further refined with additional prompts. So it is important to learn how to create prompts and then refine those prompts based on responses when you use AI. For example, if I want to make a speech on the creation of Wonder Woman as a comic book character, I can ask the chatbot, "Who created Wonder Woman?" Then I can refine that response by asking more specific questions about the creator, such as his education, his inspirations, and how Wonder Woman related to his real life. Checking facts. Next, AI generates responses using a mix of data sources. The problem is that some of those data sources are inaccurate. AI might not be able to tell the difference between good and bad information. Consider AI as a helpful, but not well-informed friend. This friend wants to help but cannot tell if they make a mistake. So you should use the AI-generated responses as a starting point and then carefully research to ensure that what you submit in class is accurate. Otherwise, you will be submitting bad work that will negatively impact your grade and credibility. One of the fears about AI is that it will replace us humans in our current and future jobs. So if you do not want to be replaced by AI in your current and future careers, then AI should not replace you in your classes. Editing. After you have refined and fact-checked your AI-generated responses, it is time to edit the text. As an individual, you are unique, so your work should reflect you and your uniqueness. For example, I asked ChatGPT-4 to write a statement similar to what I just said. It responded, "As a student, your distinctiveness lies in your unique perspective and voice. This uniqueness should be distinctly evident in your work." So you can clearly see how the response from ChatGPT-4 does not reflect my voice. This means that you should carefully edit your submissions to reflect your voice. Otherwise, you are replacing your own unique voice with that of AI. This can lead to issues of academic integrity now, and this also puts you in greater danger of being put out of work by AI now and in the future. Citing and referencing. Lastly, it is vital that you cite and reference information that you receive from AI. Remember, AI-generated works are not your own, so you must cite and reference them to avoid plagiarism in class. You must also do this outside of class for work to avoid being perceived as a fraud. The citation and reference should include the name of the AI tool, the company or organization that created it, and the year the reference was generated. please check with your instructor for specific style details. Summary. In summary, we discussed some quick tips for using AI in your class. We addressed these elements. First, a brief introduction of AI. Second, prompt engineering. Third, checking facts. Fourth, editing. And fifth, citing and referencing. I'm Dr. Norma Jones. Thank you for watching.